Hello, my dear students. I am very happy to meet you all through the online platform. I would like to congratulate you all for the success of your next academic year 21-22. I wish you all the very best for your bright future. And in today's English class, I am going to teach you the poem Life. Life is the poem. Written by Henry Van Dyke. A short introduction about the poet Henry Van Dyke. Henry Van Dyke was an American author, poet, educator, and clergyman. He served as a professor of English literature at Princeton University between 1899 and 1923. He was selected to the American Academy of Arts and Letters and received many other honors. Students, life. Life is beautiful. Life is to be enjoyed. Life is full of thrills and suspense. All these wordings we might have experienced in our day-to-day life. Yes, students, learning is also a part of life. In our day-to-day life, we are learning so many things. Learning is a lifetime process. So don't quit from this. Keep on learning. As a part of your learning, today's poem has been posted to you. Yes, life is to be enjoyed. How to lead our life? Life gives us a positive view about life. The poem Life gives us a positive view about life. In life, we face many obstacles, but we should face it with boldness and with a cheerful attitude. We should enjoy our life moment by moment, like a boy hoping for the best future. Before I give you the explanation of the poem, let me read the poem. Please listen the poem carefully. Life. Let me but live my life from year to year with forward face and unreluctant soul. Not hurrying to nor turning from the goal. Not mourning for the things that disappear. In the dim past, nor holding back in fear. From what the future veils, but with a whole and happy heart that pays its toll. To youth and age, and travels on with cheer. So let the wave wind up the hill or down, over rough or smooth, the journey will be joy. Still seeking what I sought when but a boy, new friendship. High adventure and a crown. My heart will keep the courage of the quest and hope the road's last return will be the best. Henry Van Dyke. Henry Van Dyke wanted to live a better life each moment, looking forward to complete his work unhesitatingly. But he did not want to hurry up to achieve his aim. He would like to complete his tasks undiverted. While pursuing his desire, he is not ready to mourn for the loss or failure gone by. He does not fear what the future is going to give. He is ready to continue his work till his last breath with gay and happy attitude. In his view, whether he faces upcoming setbacks and crosses thorny and smooth surfaces, he will enjoy his journey of life. He says he is in the mood of a lad who entertains new friends, ready to do risky tasks to reach his desire. Finally, he expresses that with courageous fervor, he would continue his journey, hoping for a best tomorrow. The poet wants to stress the three important factors through his line. What does the poet wanted to stress, you know? To lead our life, we should be positive mind, and he explains that there is a purposeful meaning behind our life that we are leading, and the life that we are leading should be a fruitful one. So the poet is very determined to live a purposeful, positive and fruitful life. So let me give the explanation of the poem. In the first stanza fully, the poet explains the positivity and the fruitfulness explained in that line. Let me but live my life from year to year. The poet wants to lead his life from year to year. And how he wants to lead his life, you know? With forward face, with positive thinking and unreluctant soul. Unreluctant means willing to do anything. See, we must be in mind to lead our life with full of positivity, and we should be in a position to do anything. Not hurrying to, not turning from the goal, not mourning for the things that disappear. The poet wants to lead his life with lots of positivity, and at the same time he is not at all ready to mourn for the hurry to achieve his lifetime goal, and he is not at all ready to mourn for the things that is going to vanish from his lifetime. In the dim past, now holding back in fear. Here, dim past, the meaning for the term dim past is refers to the things or the events which go away and it will not be remembered clearly. See, sometimes there are some events or the incidents that will retain in our mind. Often it will come and go. So for that, we should not be in a fearful manner. And we do not know what will happen in the future. Our future incidents are hidden. Veils means covered. The meaning for the word veils means covered. Our future is covered. And with a whole heart, we should lead our life with wholehearted happiness. And that is given to us. And the wholehearted happiness of life should be lead from the youth age to the old age. And we should travel our life with more cheerful. And in the second stanza, the poet further expresses his determination to have a great life. How to have a great life? We should be treat the ups and downs equal in our life. When you start to treat the ups and downs in our life equally, our life journey will be joy. And we should lead, still seeking what I sought, but a boy. At the young age, we used to forget all our worries, and we may seek the adventurous things, and through the adventures we might have obtained a crown, a special gift. With that attitude, we should lead our life. And the poet in the last two lines, he concludes the poem by saying that our heart must be courage. And we should have the mind to have a long search. It's hard for us to find what is given in our life. So we must have the quest. We must have the long search to find it what is given in our life. And we must have the confidence that our lifetime will be the best return. Our lifetime will give us the best return. So this is the content of the poem. And in the next video, let me explain the structure of the poem and what are the important poetic devices employed here. and the rhyming scheme and rhyming words employed in this poem. Till then, thank you for watching this. Thank you, students.